This is the $42 Kolber PL5 Pocket Light, a handy pocketable LED for your photo and video needs. Pocket lights like this usually have limited functionality in the professional world of filming. But in the digital world where creativity usually triumphs over technical capability, it certainly gets the job done. While I did find the Kolber PL5 a handy accessory tool for my social media and YouTube needs, it's not a perfect product. You have to be specific with what you require from a pocket LED if you plan on getting Kolber's latest PL5 light. Starting with the unboxing, the package houses quite a few items: the PL5 LED itself, a packaging bag, a relatively lengthy USB-C cable, a cold shoe mount, and two metal plates. The included cold shoe mount is a mix of plastic and metal. Though I find the ball head to be of flimsy quality, the lock mechanisms get the job done. The USB-C cable supplements 5 watts of power when charging the PL5. Kolber advertises 2.5 hours of charging time before reaching 100%, and I found that to be accurate for the decent-sized 2100mAh battery. Within the first hour, the PL5 fast charges to 50%. But for some reason, I never saw the battery indicator hit 100% even after 3 hours of charging. Be it a software or hardware issue, just take note that you can unplug the PL5 upon hitting 99%. But when it comes to actual use, the PL5 lasts longer than advertised. I think it's one of the long-lasting pocket LEDs on the market. With its temperature set at 6500K and brightness at max, the PL5 took 1 hour and 44 minutes to beat its 90 minutes claim. And just for fun, I tried the same settings but at 50% brightness. It took me 5 hours to empty the PL5's tank. Now, to give you a bit of context, the PL5 produces up to 1500 lux at 30 centimeters, which by the way, with the setting at the coldest temperature of 6500K. You can go as low as 2700K, which is lower than other pocket LEDs. A total of 48 beads can be seen from the light itself, with 24 apiece for cool and warm tones. To make it a bit more technical, Kolber claims that the color rendering index of the PL5 is around 95%, just 5% shy of a light's ability to show the true colors of an object. That's about it for the performance of the PL5. As for the actual build of Kolber's pocket light, the entirety is made of solid plastic in a lightweight size that's only slightly bigger than a credit card. The beads up front is covered with a diffuser, and you'll need to purchase separate gel extensions if you wish to play around with RGB lighting, which is unfortunate not to see here since other pocket LEDs have it as bundles already. Nevertheless, the PL5 is a cool performer even in humid weather. There's about 3 grills around the build to ensure overheat won't ever be a problem. The back certainly gets busier with a power slash function button, a colored digital display, and a metal plate for attaching the PL5 against metallic surfaces. Long pressing the power button will wake the device, and a short press will let you switch between two modes, CCT and EFF. The display shows the mode you're in, as well as the battery indicator. Kolber uses an approximate number of hours for the battery life, but I would prefer having a percentage guide instead since it's more accurate based on my usage. Under CCT, the PL5 lets you control the temperature and brightness of the pocket light with a rather flimsy but functional button on the right-hand side, just right above the USB-C port. You have to give the button a nudge or a nudge and hold to adjust the setting of the PL5. Press the power button and you'll be switching to EFF mode, which gives you 2 special lighting styles for an extra flare for videos, and these styles are lightning mode and fire mode. Lightning mode makes the beads blink in 3 kinds of sequence. And fire mode imitates the natural bounds of a fire with quick successions, also in 3 kinds of sequence. The INF basically lets you control the intensity of the light itself. The huge metal plating on the back of the build lets you attach the PL5 against metallic objects. But in the case of Kolber, the company provided 2 more metal plates in the box, along with ready-to-peel adhesive to be attached to the back of a smartphone. It gives you the ability to easily capture photos and videos without having to play around with the angle of light if that's what you're trying to accomplish. But if you want more flexibility, the quarter-inch screw hole is at your disposal if you have a tripod lying around, or you can just attach the included cold shoe mount to your camera. If you're limited with mounts, you don't need to worry as the PL5 itself offers one more fun-under accessory, such as the microphone. To sum up, Kolber PL5 may be limited in RGB lighting, but the functionality and flexibility it offers make up for it. The extra cold shoe mount makes it an easy on-the-go camera setup for vlogging, and you always have the option to use the PL5 with a tripod for a much more intentional lighting effect. And if you only need better lighting for your social media needs, though you need to be mindful of the adhesive after the fact, it still makes shooting easy with a smartphone. Culver has yet to share when it'll go up for sale, but I left their links in the description to let you get notified when that happens. So that's it for this one, and until the next one, stay safe.